I'm here with John McGinnis, a competitor from Team Synergy for this year's Green Flight Challenge. And John, welcome. Well, tell us about your airplane.
We are flying Synergy, which is a novel double box tail configuration aircraft. It's quite striking, very different. It's a six-fold application of everything that's been learned about drag reduction. It focuses on a simultaneous application of both induced drag reduction and laminar flow technologies with an open thermodynamic cycle. The airplane is flying through a volume of air. When it hits that air, some of it sticks to the plane and you drag it along with you. And the objective with an active system is to take that air that's stuck to the airplane, re-energize it, and spit it back out the back. Synergy actually came about because of my strong interest and desire to make an electric aircraft. Mm-hmm. If you want to make an electric aircraft, you have to look at the fact that you've got at least a 10-to-1 energy storage deficit to overcome somehow. Mm-hmm. But it also turns out that we've got about a 5 or 6-to-1 opportunity space by applying advanced aerodynamic principles. So if I was able to make good use of aerostructural considerations, good integration of propulsion into the airframe, and make good use of these aerodynamic principles I've been talking about, then I could possibly conceive of a practical electric airplane. So Synergy was my answer to what a practical electric airplane will look like in the future. And when that breakthrough happened, it actually overshadowed my ability to do two projects of that sort at once. So I elected to design it around a good diesel engine, the Delta Hawk diesel engine. It's a turbo diesel, four-cylinder, two-stroke diesel with a turbocharger. And so it's designed, Synergy is designed specifically for that engine, but after we've proven the airframe concepts and have a little bit more data in validation, I would hope that we will be rapidly able to start developing those electric versions and hybrid electric versions that make the most sense. What Synergy is a double box tail. Mm-hmm. So the airfoils that are above and behind the wing at the tips are actually generating a substantial down force. Mm. Very high amount of it, as a matter of fact. And that's because we get to act against the wake vortex that comes off the tip of an airplane, and we're acting against it with a third airfoil, not just a winglet, but the upper surfaces as well. Mm-hmm. And so when you do that, you increase your span efficiency. Mm-hmm. You increase the structural rigidity of the wing. Mm-hmm. You lighten up the system. Mm-hmm. So we have the induced drag advantage of a wing that's probably 46 feet long, but we've made it into a nice little 32-foot package.
Right, and it also seems to create kind of a channel for the propulsion system as well.
Well, that's true, not just for the propulsion system, but in aeronautical engineering, when you have two airfoils, one above the other, you have to consider what's called biplane interference. Mm-hmm. And that's usually a very negative thing. It disrupts the ability of these individual airfoils to do their job. But that's an assumption we forget. There's two sides to that coin. You can have both negative interference, which is what our calculations always put in, or you can have constructive interference. And Synergy makes use of constructive interference such that we have a Venturi effect over mm-hmm. the wing, and the individual airfoils together are able to affect more air mass than either of them alone.
Is there a torque or P factor associated with this design that is different from a conventional airplane?
Well, we don't have a P factor because the prop wash is not touching anything. Uh-huh. That's one of the major advantages. Torque is torque, and because we have a high amount of power, we have a pretty conventional amount of torque.
Mm-hmm. And will you have a constant speed prop on this airplane?
No. What we're using is an example of unducted wake propulsion. It's similar to a prop fan, but making use of the fact that it's in the boundary layer, that it's in the lee of a laminar flow body, and that there's a suction applied to the aft body of the fuselage so that we have a manifestation of pressure thrust. We're not saying Goldschmied pressure thrust. Uh-huh. That's a concept that brings to mind a lot of conflicts between wake propulsion and advanced drag reduction. But this propeller is fixed in pitch, mm-hmm. and it's more of an impeller. what we're really trying to do is make suction, not throw air out the back.
Right, right.
So it has more blades. And in truth, the propellers that we've illustrated synergy with are not the propellers that we're flying.
Is the laminar flow that you're getting on along the fuselage, is it ducted into the engine compartment for cooling, or is you know, how is that addressed?
First of all, cooling drag is a very large percentage of what penalizes most airplanes.
Mm-hmm.
That is anathema to someone who's trying to use energy efficiently, because we have all this heat that represents energy. So I've tried to take the heat energy that the engine is putting out and put it to very good use. So our, instead of having a cooling drag component, we believe we'll have a net cooling thrust.
Uh-huh.
We have small intakes, and at the intakes we have a geometric condition that minimizes the drag consequence of the intake. When it comes into, through a very long expanding duct, into a very large expansion plenum, it goes through our air cooler, our intercooler, our oil cooler, and cools off my turbocharger, cools off my exhaust.
Mm-hmm.
And after I've made it cool everything I possibly can, it exits the vehicle through a exhaust augmenting scavenging system.
Mm-hmm.
At very high velocity.
Do you have a pilot selected for?
We do. Lieutenant Colonel Tom Reynolds retired. He was the senior military research test pilot at NASA Ames.
Oh, wow.
And his credentials are 5 miles long.
Uh-huh.
He was a professor of aerodynamics at West Point, a graduate of the Naval Test Pilot School.
Are you feeling like you're going to have an opportunity to practice flying this race course ahead of time before you come down?
Or? Yes. Well, of course, you get to do that in the flight simulator all the time. That's
yeah.
Nice. We've now flown down to Santa Rosa a couple times, so
uh-huh.
We're familiar with the area. And as far as practicing flying the airplane, we want to do that as much as we possibly can.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
We are very much in striking distance of winning the largest aviation prize in history.
Mm-hmm. Well, best of luck, and we're excited to see you show up and compete.
We will be very excited to be here.
It's going to be, you know, it is a remarkable airplane to see. Its design is you know, radically different than anything else, and it's going to turn a lot of heads, I'm sure.
Thank you. You know, I want to say this. A large part of what is in this is a direct consequence of the work that CAFE Foundation has been doing from way back when.
Yeah.
So it takes a long time for these things to bear fruit, but I think that work is now starting to mature.
Yeah. Thanks a lot.